such an amazing person, and the community lost like a pillar. We call him a superhero, but I think that's an understatement.
How do you sum up the life of a man who's touched thousands of people?
I think you only come across somebody like that once, one in a million, and you could only be so lucky as to like know Hans.
For the people who knew Hans Hughes, the Downtown Phoenix ambassador was magic.
He was one of those people that touched everybody. When you met Hans, no matter who you were, you got the Hans experience.
I feel so thankful to see so many people here.
Last week, Hans passed away from a pulmonary embolism while recovering from serious injuries after he was hit by a drunk driver while riding his bike home from work. Saturday night, hundreds of those who were lucky to get that Hans experience gathered to remember and share just how much he mattered to each of them and his beloved city.
Central in Washington, when the light rail goes by, he's like known for standing on that corner and just waving to the trains. And that's his way of saying hello to people as they come downtown.
For 12 years, Hans sowed seeds of direction to downtown visitors.
This year I planted a whole garden of sunflowers, so this is very appropriate.
And although he's gone, the people he touched say they will continue to follow that direction.
His legacy is just big, bold, passionate love. Something that we always used to say together was life is good, love is real.
So how do you sum up the life of a man who touched thousands of people? For Hans Hughes, a simple smile and wave.
Slow down and be empathetic to people. And if we can honor him and take that out to the world, what a beautiful thing for him.
In downtown Phoenix, Josh Sanders, 12 News.
I'm going to be the MC for tonight, and just a quick rundown of what we're going to do tonight. We're about to start the night off with a prayer from Hans' sister Hannah, and then after that we're going to open it up to Hans' family to take their time to say whatever they need to say in regards to their family member. And then we're going to take a quick break. We're going to do like a little mix and mingle. Hans would have wanted everybody here to make a new friend, and so that's what we'd like for people to do in between the breaks. And then once that break is up, then we're gonna turn it over to downtown Phoenix, people that have worked with him pretty much every single day of his life during a job that he absolutely loved. And then after that, we're going to open it up to the community. Because of COVID reasons, we ask that you just don't touch the mic, just so everybody stays safe. I'll be able to take care of the volume and whatnot. The mic will be right up here on the stand, and I'll adjust it if you need it. And then just be respectful of time for the community. No more than about 2 minutes if you want to say something. And then, but when that time comes, I'll direct you guys, okay? So, Hannah, if you would like to come on up, we're going to open up with a prayer.
Behold, I see my father and my mother. I see all my dead relatives seated. I see my master seated in heaven, and heaven is beautiful and green. With him are men and servants, and he calls me. Take me to him. I lift my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will never slumber or sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. May the angels welcome you and lead you through the All-Father's great battlefield. May they sing your name with love and fury, so that we might hear it rise from the depths of heaven and know that you've taken your rightful place at the table of kings. For a great man has fallen, a warrior, a son, a brother, and a friend. Amen.
Let's give it a round, ladies and gentlemen. At this time, we'll ask you to stand up for a moment if you want to come up and speak.
Thank you all for coming. Please allow me just to read one more Bible passage. I went over to the house today. He had a Bible sitting on his table, and I just kind of resonated with that.
My name is Peter Kirkendall, and I'm Hans Hughes' brother-in-law. You saw three of my children come up and give their thoughts about Hans, and I'm proud of them just like Hans would be proud of them. Hans welcomed me into his family 15 years ago, and he welcomed me with open arms, just as I'm sure that he welcomed you all into his family with open arms. Because I know that each and every one of you here today, Hans loved, and Hans probably gave a hug to, he listened to you, and he gave feedback. And I thank you all for coming. Hans, I love you, and I know you're watching right now. Thank you.
Pete's a little bit taller. Hey, I'm David. I'm going to get all choked up, so I'll keep this relatively short. Hans was a really beautiful person. I see a lot of beautiful people out there right now. It's a beautiful moment. Thank you all for being here. It really means a lot to me and this family. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. This is a big crowd. It's a little scary now. Thank you so much for coming out. My name is Brian. I'm Hans's cousin. We grew up together, and he's always been that same bright, shining star. He always had that smile. He was always warm, nothing behind us. And I think he left us a message, and that message was love. You know, Uncle Morris, I love you. Aunt Judy, I love you. Mom, Sarah. Love you guys, and I think if we want to honor Hans, slow down. Next time you feel an anger towards someone or ill thought, think of what Hans would want. You know, I think he had the ability to just kind of absorb life, slow down, and be empathetic to people. And if we can honor him and take that out to the world, what a beautiful thing. I don't want to have any regrets in this life. I want to say I love you, Hans. All you bastards in the orange, you guys are amazing. I know you're his family here. I lost track of, lost touch with Hans over the last 10 or 12 years or so. And to see see this outpouring of emotion and love on Facebook, and the people's lives you touched. This has been, I don't know, it's given me a strength that I never thought I had in there. I think it's so beautiful. So thank you guys so much for coming out. I think, you know, just honor that love. Thank you.
That's my Uncle Morris, and that's Hans's father, and his father and my father were brothers. It's hard to admit, but there's a huge age difference between me and Hans. I'm 25 years older. So I always kind of saw Hans as an aunt would a nephew. And I can assure you that since he was a toddler, into his teens, into his early 20s, he always had the same smile, the same giving spirit. And when this happened, I kind of lost track of him after we moved out here. All of you probably know him as the man who became much better than I do. But I can tell you, I just couldn't believe how those qualities that he had, that he was born with, grew, became more powerful, and radiated out to everyone. And when my Uncle Morris talked about Christ, I think what we had on our hands was an earthbound savior, and he was flawed, I'm sure, funny, and mortal. But he taught us between all of us, and all I can do is say, I want to say something else. The last year has been really hard for all of us, and the political climate's been tough the last few years, and everybody fussing and fighting about how to handle this pandemic, and then this happens. I'm looking at his Facebook page, I'm talking to people that were close to him, and all of a sudden, all I see is love and positivity. Love and positivity, and I needed that, everybody needs that, and I just hope we can kind of keep it going in our own small, flawed, earthbound savior ways. Thank you.
Kids, we lived in Phoenix. I hate the heat. Sorry.
right up where we left off. Whether it was tours of the local coffee shops, the local pubs, the local art stores, everything and anything local, and all those deep conversations that came with Hans. I'm seeing now that it was not just my isolated experience, but all across the expanse of Hans's relationships, he was honest, real, and genuine with each soul he touched. How immensely incredible is that? What an incredible, rare, unique individual he was. What a legendary champ. My husband Peter, he spoke already, he started joking with Hans about a year ago about how they were going to erect a bronze statue of Hans in downtown Phoenix. And after talking to multiple people this week, he wasn't the only one with that idea. So just give it time. It may just eventually happen. This is the party I planned, or I imagined for Hans when he recovered. I swore that I would give each and every one of you a hug so that you could feel my immense, never-ending gratitude and love for all the support my family has been shown from you. Phoenix friends, you lifted us up and you carried us through this tragedy. We cried together, we rejoiced together, we laughed together, and now we grieve together. But tonight we can celebrate the legend that is Hans. I still stand by my words. We love you, Phoenix. And it's been said that family doesn't mean blood, so welcome to the Hughes family.
Now we're just going to take about 5-10 minutes, and we're just going to make a new friend. And you know, Hans didn't want us to be all sad tonight, so let's pick it up and act just a little bit. And then we're going to hear from Phoenix Downtown Ambassador. How's that sound, guys? Yeah, make a new friend, guys. Thank you.
manager at Z Pizza inquired about what I do at my job. He saw me in my orange and tan uniform coming in during my lunch breaks to get some delicious pizza that they had. He was always nice, helpful, and chatted me up every time that I was there. I informed him what the job entailed, and he seemed interested. One day I told him we were hiring and that he should apply for the job with our team. I was convinced after getting to know him that he would be perfect for the job. I was even one of the three people that were there in his interview. Hans went above and beyond any expectations I had of him once he became a Downtown Phoenix ambassador and created his place on our team as one of the best. What I like to say is that I convinced Hans to make the jump to Lightspeed and become an ambassador. Since then, it is all history, as Hans created it in his own way, making a huge impact on the downtown community. And all of you here tonight know this. After having experiences with him, and becoming friends, and having a piece of his life intermingled with yours. So I'd like to say, on my last radio call to Hans, Chuck and Hans, you will carry on and remain the embodiment of what it is to be a Downtown Phoenix ambassador. Until we meet again, brother, we love you, Hans.
Experiences. Whatever that means to you, just go out there and create it.
Thank you. personal level, I bear the names of the loved ones that I have lost throughout the years. I hope that Vasily somewhere somehow will bear his name so that we don't forget. We'll be very, very hurt, but the city as a whole needs to remember him. What he meant to all of us.
good enough to stay here. And I knew he was a good guy because the moment he saw me, he recognized who I was. He's like, oh, you went to this school. And he knew my name, actually, before I even introduced myself, which is kind of great, honestly. It makes you feel good. And that's just the type of guy he was. Everything he said was genuine to me. We would have these crazy conversations at work, I mean, just about life, things we're doing, our aspirations. And he always told me one thing is, do what makes you happy and make sure you're doing the best you can. And I believe Hans always did that. That's the way I'm happy.
What he does out here and, you know, how he treats us as like his employees, like his coworkers, but like just to see him in that normal form, you know what I mean? Like, it was just so awesome. Like, so awesome to see. And the last one was kind of crazy because before the incident happened, I was downtown going to just one of the restaurants, and I ran into him, and we talked for a little bit on the corner, but I asked him to take a picture for us. I asked him to take a picture for me and Lisa, but after that moment is where I kind of got a heartfelt moment with him, because we didn't, like, always being at work see eye to eye. We didn't have any arguments or anything like that, you know what I mean? But it was just like, you know, sometimes Hans being Hans, it's like, this whole day, like, jeez, like. But he actually came up to me and for me at the time, I didn't know even why, but he just apologized for not, like, I'm trying to word it word for word, and he just apologized for not getting a chance to know me more. I just thought it was real, like, I don't know, like, heartfelt, or just came and felt the need to apologize to him or something. That probably didn't even happen, or we didn't even have a type of, you know, feud against each other, which we didn't. But again, that was another, you know, human form of Hans. So it was very good to see him, you know, at the beginning stages where he's teaching me everything, he's in his mold, to where he's out doing what he loves to do for sure. I got the chance to see him happy in his truest form, you know, rocking out at the festival next to me. And then I also got to see just the soft side of Hans as well, you know. So it kind of hurts me to be up here talking about this, about him at this time, just literally because a week before this happened, I literally just seen him. But I just wanted to share those moments just to let everyone know, like, how he was to, you know, us individually. We all have separate moments with him. I kind of got a little bit of best of both worlds, which is awesome. But he's just a loving soul. He gave me inspiration. He gave me courage to go out and do something that's totally different from what I'm normally doing. And he taught me my ways. So anything that I was out here doing was from him, literally. So rest in peace, Hans. Ambassador team, we love you. All of these people here, we love you. Your family love you. You know that. And I hope you rest in peace. Thank you.
Very weird for me, and I don't think a lot of us do that enough, and
I remember Hans always telling me that, make sure you're present, don't buy the cornflakes. So everyone can see you. Hi guys. And it's something I'm always going to take with me throughout life now. I had the pleasure of seeing Hans a couple times when I was down here a few months ago. I talked to him in one spot, of course, just be seen, be visible, saw him in another spot. I still have to talk to Hans, he's still my buddy. So what if you not just talk about, of course, I'd say, oh, what are the businesses? What's the light rail doing? How's the city doing? Because he's the only guy, honestly, in this whole Arizona world of mine that really cared about that stuff. And that stuff helps his community be happier, his community be better. And I'm just going to try as hard as I can to make Hans proud. And he's the most Phoenician, not Phoenician, I've ever met in my entire life. And that's what I'm going to choose to live up to every day and be happier and turn on. Because that's what Hans was. As soon as you in deployment, he reads what's happening, and just that's when you're supposed to turn on. That orange shirt, as if it has a light switch on it, is on, and you're beyond, basically. And I'm grateful. I'm so grateful I met that guy. He's amazing, and there's not really much more to say than that. Hans is amazing.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. What a turnout for such a guy. You know, my name's Ian, and I met Hans 9 years ago. And the thing that always stuck with me was he asked me my name one time. And he never forgot. Even though we could go 6 months without seeing each other. Also, one of my favorite things, I do walk on the road downtown here. I was just here. Ian! Good afternoon! Cruise off, you know. But I think we should all remember that, you know, as we cope with the loss of his life, which is one of the brightest I've ever known, we need to remember that it's our responsibility to continue his legacy of passion and understanding and positivity. And I think that's the best way we can honor him.
All right, guys, so we are just about that time. We're going to take another quick break, but before we do that, let's give it up for the ambassadors one more time. Thank you guys for speaking. So I had the opportunity to work with Hans at St. Pizza, so I feel like this is the perfect place for me to step in and just speak about our little experience, and then we'll transition over to friends, because I was also, Hans was a very, very good friend of mine. He was actually one of my best friends, and he knows probably more about me than my husband does. And so, just a really quick story about Hans. We have so many stories. I've known Hans for over about 16 years. Like I said, we worked at Z Pizza together, and I went to Wells Fargo, he went to the Ambassadors, and then we kind of just, we lived that life. But one of the craziest things I'll forever remember about Hans is I actually helped him get the house that he lived in till his passing. And I'll never forget, because I lived in the house right next door to him. And I was cleaning my house one time, and I put this carpet out. I like shook this carpet out and put it on the fence. And this was Hans. This was like absolutely Hans. This is when I first got the idea of like, oh my goodness, who is this man? And so I put the carpet out, I'm cleaning, I'm singing in my house, doing my thing. And I get this loud knock on this door. It's boom, 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 boom. And I'm like, what the hell is that? What is going on? And I go to the door, and it's Hans. And it's crazy air Hans, and he's like, he's got my carpet in his hand. And he's like, Kelvin, you're bringing down the property value of my home. And I said, Hans, if you don't put my damn carpet down on that fence, you are renting, sir. But that was Hans. And like, that's just how crazy Hans was. And like, I want to tell that story because Hans was a big, beautiful man, and he was, and I don't mean crazy as in crazy, I just mean, when you had a Hans experience, it was like, what the hell just happened? Like, that was Hans for you, so those are those Hanses. And so, take about 5 minutes, make another friend, go to the bathroom, guys, and then we're going to have friends up.
If you returned the bikes that were not parked at the dock. So Hans and I would meet at his place at like 10 in the morning, we'd fuel up, we'd have so much espresso, and we'd race to see who could return more bikes. And on Sundays, we would go, no joke, until like 10, 11 o'clock at night and see how many bikes we could return. And I remember one Sunday, we went to Greenwich Pastico and we had a victory meal because we had returned a lot of bikes. And I'm like, Hans, my group bike membership is paid for the next like 6 months. And I'm laughing about it. And he's like, yeah, but what really matters is that we put the bikes back where they belong. And I didn't even think of that, you know? I'm like, yeah, group bike, cool. Another funny memory, we went up to Flagstaff Folk Festival together, and we got there and decided that we weren't going to talk the whole festival. So imagine going to a folk festival, and we decided we wanted to just listen to our music and draw. And so for like 2 days, we barely spoke. Again, weird stuff, really weird stuff. But the magic, and the reason I'm sharing this is because it's really powerful to encounter a person who's so unapologetically themselves and to love and be in a partnership with someone who really accepted that and who you could have that much fun with. It has instilled in me a desire to have fun with all of the people that I love all of the time. My heart goes out to his family. You can go on Instagram. I'm so sorry for your loss. Thank you for sharing Hans with me and with the city and for helping teach me to stop and smell the flowers and bike around the city at all hours of the night and go to the garden and pick the carrots even if it's 2 a.m. because you're worried that by 6 a.m. they won't be as good as them anymore. So thank you.
Don't be shy, guys. Come on up. Don't be shy.
You guys are a good job, really. Buenas noches.
I want to tell you about the first and the last time I made hands, I had interaction with hands. The first time, it was something like 2007, and my new friend, Kevin Patterson, convinced me after day drinking on a Sunday to crash the Firehouse house meeting. Because these people are fucking crazy, and you can't, you know, the shit that they say is so cool, and you'll make notes, you know. I was already doing sketches and notes at the time, so I was like, okay, well, I'm all for a sketch, but isn't this like private? No, they're cool. So we got there, and the meeting has already started. It's like 6 p.m. or something, and we silently, the kind of silence and discretion that the really drunk people think they have, you know, you just doing all this fucking silent movie thing to hide your intoxication. And we sat down and they were arguing about the washing dishes duties. And they were very, very articulate about, I don't think it's right for me. And yeah, sure, I was immediately thrown into it. The moment there was a break in whatever monologue we sat through, Hans raised his hand and didn't wait for somebody to say, your turn. He just said, you know, stood up, obviously gave us the, I am called too, and with the voice, I just don't think it's proper that these two strangers sit here when we are discussing private matters. I mean, it finished like, I don't know, 4 years at this point? No, sorry, 7 years, but I actually just felt at home for the last four. So I'm still having the immigrant trauma, you know, and this giant white guy with a booming voice is telling me that I'm not wanted there. This is Arpaio gear. So I'm like, oh, fuck, I'm gonna get shot. I'm looking at Kevin like, why did you do that, you know? For the record, I actually asked Hans about this moment several times, and he wouldn't even remember. He's like, really, that happened? Like, yeah, you were so fucking... we apologize, you know? Michael Tony 3 did a big show to let me stay. You saw artists. They're documenting the moment. And I can echo all the moments when he just made a shitty moment be grand, and the moment that he all those moments in which we either block party or were hangover together, but the last moment or the last things that I remember about him was very, very pre-pandemic and of course through the whole this whole fucking horrible last 2 years. How I would hear his voice booming from somewhere in downtown Phoenix. And I would see him in the distance and we would just raise our fists with masks. And this is the same city in which I felt so alone and disregarded for so many years. And I remember those last times going, oh my God, how things changed. Now I have this guardian. And I'm gonna miss him, and I'm trying real hard to focus on the message. But it's hard, Hans, it's hard. We're gonna miss that fucking voice telling us that it's okay. Gracias.
Thank you. Keep going, guys. Don't be shy. Come on up. Let's celebrate.
It's really hard with the words. Like what Hans or who, but it's amazing to see all these people. My name is Christina. I belong from the Firehouse family, and I was also lucky to run as an ambassador. I worked as an ambassador to him in the last 5 years. So I've been seeing Hans on and off for definitely he had that switch. When he came to work, he was on work, and he was focused on finding people and making sure that the best downtown was here, and he was making sure that there was no talk of like what was going on after work or anything like that. It was work. And so it's kind of neat to see both sides of that. I met him when he was at the firehouse, and then he came back to downtown and became an ambassador. I worked first Fridays and everything, and I was so jealous. I was a tour guide at downtown. I said, man, I want to be an ambassador with Hans, and I worked really hard, and I finally got it. And I worked with him the last 5 years. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you for sharing your world with us, and your voice, and your kindness, and your love. We will hear the heart.
Share a text that Hans sent to me. Okay, it illustrates the kind of person he was. It says, "Hi Brandon. Today I'm remembering those that have helped protect my freedoms." I don't know. And those that have helped protect my heart in friendships. Thank you. That's what I said. And I said, "This message really touched me. Thanks, Hans. Love you, buddy." And he said, "Love you too." Fuck, we're so lucky we got to know Hans. Holy shit. Thank you, Hans!
Keep going, guys. Let's go. Let's go.
This is great.
Don't be shy, guys. Come on down.
many of them from there. The universe was kind enough. But just blowing up from work, I've been trying to really come to terms with what's happening. And knowing that we really have to say goodbye to one of us. But so, on a lighter note, I've been honest as he looks like a rock star, he looks like a wrestler. He looks like a nightmare. I don't know if I was ever a rock star, I don't know if I mean to see him. Knowing the things I know now, I know that we was probably afterwards. So, I go from distress to like, but coming here, I throughout the day, like I said, for me it's just a matter of really wanting to say goodbye and carrying on with legacy. So on the one hand, I know Hans says, welcome everybody. I want to have Hans, but looking at all the pictures and hearing the stories and things like that, I want to say, what are these comments? Until next time.
Addictive, and so just go outside and just pay it forward and
You know, some people come to work and then they clock in and they clock back out and they get their paychecks back. Hans lived that essence that he lived that I want to help others, and you don't find that all of the time. And to hear all the ambassadors say things like above and beyond, because that's a thing that we do in the office, is we work above and beyond. You don't just do a normal job, you don't just say hi, you say hi with heart. And I'm gonna mess this up, but Lisa is 1017 in row. Yeah, so tonight I just feel like Hans is saying, Hans to Sam, I'm 1017 to heaven. And I just thank him and literally wait with the train. I will come back and bring you up. And just be that. And I think the biggest thing is that you don't think about how to be like Hans. You just listen to your heart and you get vulnerable and you go outside and make merry. And I just appreciate having somebody really embody that all of these years. So thank you, Lois, for letting me get up here and cheer up.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause for Hans one more time. Just so you guys know, I've been recording this entire night, and I'll be putting together a video of tonight. And what I would absolutely love for everybody to do is to group up together and just face that camera and say a message that I and Hans have always said. Something I've always said is life is good, love is real. And I would say that to Hans on the street, and every time I see Hans, I say, Hans, hello, life is good, and you can say, love is real. So I'd love for us to look at this camera, just into a group and just look at this camera, and then I'm going to say life is good, and then you guys are going to say love is real. Let's do that 3 times for Hans Suelo. Here we go, on 3. 1, 2, 3. Life is good.
Check the